Now then, welcome back to another episode of New Ariador. I'm out and about today, but I'm planning on running around doing all sorts of show and tell today. Lots of things need showing, lots of things need telling. I am going to be doing one of those episodes where I get a lot done just by talking a lot. I've been doing a bit. There's been a few things that happened during the week that have made it difficult to do any work towards an episode this week. Last week was a bit of a bind, a bit of a struggle. My wife, it's all real life stuff, this is nothing, nothing to do with on the server or my game time or anything like that. My game time has been slowed up and affected by my wife. And rightly so. My wife's had a lot to deal with over the last few days. The last week, really. She has her best friend who's... I'm just showing you around. Her best friend whose father has cancer and has been given a short time left to live. Which, of course, is very upsetting to her friend and all of the family. And my wife has been round there being best friends quite a lot, just to help her out. You get in there. Thank you. And also, to top that off, her own dad has been diagnosed with cancer, but it's been a long-term cancer deal. Not a quick short-term cancer. If that can be... any better, I don't know whether being given a deadline on cancer and when it's supposed to actually affect you fully is better than just not knowing when it's going to turn nasty. Cancer is one of those kind of things, isn't it? Cancer is a thing like that. It's a horrid, horrid thing to have. Many people in the world do have it, and many people are still living fairly normal lives with the big C in the overshadowing, hanging over them. I'm just basically showing you here that I've been doing a bit of work in putting beams up and structures in the mine. That's about all I've had time to do, really. I've done a few other bits and pieces which I want to show you as well, but I figure this episode, as I've got nothing planned, I should probably just show you a few things that's been happening on the server and show you a few things that other people have done. So it's kind of one of those server tour episodes that YouTubers do every now and again when they've got absolutely nothing to show you that they've done themselves, and they've got nothing planned, and they don't know what to do for an episode. They take you on a run around to show you what other people have been doing. Justifiably, hopefully you'll see, I've not been doing much more than just... messing about, really, on the server, just doing a few bits and pieces. I've done a lot of tree farming, as you can probably tell. There's a lot of oak up there, a lot of spruce up there. And I've been doing a lot of work in the nether tunnel. The nether tunnel now has a layer of ice, packed ice, all the way down it. And that was no mean feat. Packed ice all the way down it was no quick thing to do. As you can see here, it's all the way down underneath the half slabs, so you can either take the cart or you can run. The half slabs up there make it a big, big difference. You can probably run faster than the cart, to be honest. But I've managed to get all this done on Sunday, just digging it all back out, laying it all back down again. There's a packed ice, or there's an ice biome that somebody found and has done a wonderful job of linking it up in the nether hub. So maybe we'll go and have a look at all the things in the nether hub currently there. I got one missing. One half slab missing. The ideas I'm getting for making this tunnel, I'm trying to come up with ideas. I'm just messing around with a few ideas. I've put ideas in place and then I've ripped them down again. Not on large scale, not like all of it. But I've put some bits and pieces up and then... took it back down again just to try something else. So I'm not 100% sure what I want to get out of it right now. Well, that's going all the way back now, isn't it? Okay. Let's take this off and put this one on there. Somebody must have used the cart and gone the wrong way. I've also replaced with powered rails all of that side. So both sides now have powered rails going all the way to the destinations. And hopefully there's only ever one cart on each. I might use one of Peddy's railway stops. The only problem I've got there is I'm right on the edge here. So I don't really have a lot of space. That is literally the wall there. Unless I started it up there where I've got more space. In which case then this would just be a stairwell up. There's a load of new people have arrived on the server. Top of the Nether, they've been doing a lot of wither fights. If you follow all of the different people who are making videos on New Areador, you'll see that recently they've got some wither fights. They've now got a cool wither skeleton farm. Minigame area, we've seen that one. You know where that is. Hot EMI. His is the same as it was last time I saw it. Manuel has now got a banner, which looks super cool. I'm going to have to figure out getting my own banner. There's something to do at some point. M-Dog's Tunnel hasn't really improved or changed. The Packed Ice Biome. There we go. It's literally somebody has made this very nice tunnel with packed ice underneath it to give me that slippy, slidey, runny feel. Made a tunnel that goes to the Packed Ice Biome. So that's where I've just been farming up the resources. I got myself a Nem's Silky Miner and Nem's Lucky Miner, both of which I have recently enchanted, and look at the durability loss on them already. Near enough all is already halfway just from working in the Nether. But better picks I have not seen. I've got one of each, Fortune 3 and Silk Touch, and it didn't take me much enchanting either. The new vanilla enchanting methods are amazing. Nice and easy. Redur, yeah, that way. The End, yeah, we've seen that. Fortress Farming, that goes to the Nether Fortress, where you can just farm with the skeletons. But there is an actual decent farm around here as well. Blue and DJ have been that way. Janus and Nils have been that way, that's cool. Peddy, of course, that way, yeah. Lena and Sven, their tunnel. I think I've shown you their tunnel before. There's a lot going on over on their place. They've recorded a few episodes that we've seen. Bunny and Possum, of course. My Sheilas. I've shown you this one before. They're still doing loads of work over there. Here's one of the new guys. Why Timmy Why? Why Timmy Why did you choose a name with things like that in it? Why Timmy Why? And Mojang's recently allowed you to change your name as well. Never mind. And Sigi? He looks like he's done a decent bit down his tunnel. This is quite nice. I like this tunnel. I like the I like the structure of that. Is it all on ice as well? Yeah, it is. Cool. Yeah, this is one of the guys that has recently joined, like in the last week, since the Valentine's Day invites, as it were. He was one of the contest winners. I think there was four new players joined thanks to the Valentine's Day event. Four players that proved themselves to be the best of the bunch, as it were. We had lots of applicants from it. We had lots of things going on. Oh, look. Half slabs everywhere along here. Half slabs. So that is going to be leading to the farm area. They've got a farm. They've got a wither farm. And I really wanted to show you. It's wither skeleton farm. There it is. It's just down there. It's a really cool thing. I don't know exactly how I get to it, though, because I've only been watching videos. I wasn't around to actually do anything. I actually missed the server meeting the other day as well. I've missed the last 2 weeks of server meetings when the new guys have been introduced to us, and we've the week before that where we discussed the applications and contest winners to decide who was the final winners of the thing. I've missed those due to all the stuff that's happening in real life. And it sucks, because normally I don't miss those kind of things. I normally try and stay as involved as possible in everything that goes on New Areador. I try. Not that easy, though. Especially when my wife's had to go out so much over the last couple of weeks. Due to, well, reasons, yes. Good reasons, I have to say, good reasons. Already started mapping the world out. I believe the maps are set, that spawn there, and I'm somewhere way over there, miles away from everything. It's cool that someone set it all up. I think Nils was setting all the maps up, and then people have been given copies of the maps by the looks of it. But this is quite a cool little place. Already doing quite a bit of stuff around the place. Oh, already got a cool bridge. A fancy tree that's grown is nice. I've got a double-sized rose bush. What has changed in my world today? I don't know. This looks like he's doing a good job around this area. I know I'm probably spoiling something from an episode to come, but... Oh, look, there's a cool ship as well. Oh, that's awesome. I've seen one video from over this end, and I think there's a couple of them who are producing things over this side. There is a group that's working together, and I'm not sure yet which way round it's all working, which people are doing what. But this base looks cool. I like this base, and he's done a lot of work already, which is very nice. So, there'll be new links in the description. I'm sure Peddy's got all that sorted out and already sent me an email with all the stuff in. It's pretty cool. I like. And a floor full of furnaces. Can never have too many furnaces, eh? Never have too many furnaces. Another thing that's very recent in my life is... Wait, that was close. I nearly blew that up. Wait. Okay, let's get out of here. Another thing that's happened recently that's prevented me from recording to my normal schedule, apart from having to look after the kids for quite long periods of time where I would normally have recording schedules or at least prepping up for episodes so that I can record when they've all gone to bed. Another thing is I got a new computer, and it was a fair expense. But an upgrade on this one that I'm recording on now. I'm still recording on the normal PC that I generally used for the last year or so. But the upgraded one is all installed with the Windows and all the Windows updates. It's like 181 Windows updates, which is ridiculous. But I had to sit through it all and just keep clicking. Fortunately, I had the space to set it up as a separate computer. And so this computer was still running, and I was still able to do some stuff while I was waiting. They're magma cubes. When did magma cubes start coming into our place? When did magma cubes come into our nether hub? Okay. I really don't want to accidentally catch a pigman in this, do I? And I can probably take him out and then go healing myself up a bit later on. Oh, man. I did not realise that we were that close, that we would have these guys running around us. Pigmen, obviously. Yeah, pigmen all over the place. All the time, pigmen in the nether everywhere. But magma cubes in the nether, yes. But I thought they were like fortress only and they just dropped down from fortresses. I thought it was just pigmen spawning generally. Maybe and probably I am mistaken, but never mind. Okay, what else do I need to show you? Apart from the new guys that have arrived, I could go down there and have a look to see what he's up to. Doesn't look as inviting as this tunnel. This tunnel looks awesome and inviting. This tunnel, not so much. I know he's been on today doing a lot of stuff, so he's probably got a decent amount of stuff done. A mushroom island biome. I don't know if you spotted it on the map, but there's a mushroom biome island that's been linked up now as well. So we've got a guardian farm, we've got a mushroom island biome, we've got a packed ice biome, we've got a link to the end. We're doing good. We're doing good as a server. There's another round of the Abba caving going on as well, which I think I saw that yesterday Peddy and DJ had their encounter. And, well, I won't spoil it by telling you who won. The videos will be out fairly soon, no doubt. Fairly soon, as in almost straight away. Let's see the map over here. Here we go. Yeah, there's a few new places built at Spawn as well. Look, Spawn has been developed out a lot. This is my farm section down here with my house down there on the corner there with the two pockets of water. All my farms around this way, and I linked it all the way around there. That's as far as I got. I might go back and do the rest of the farms at some point. But now more houses have been set up over and around and about the place as well. There's a new one there, which is quite a large plot, quite cool looking. And there's a railway station. Oh yeah, the railway station. If you haven't seen the railway station already, Peddy and Rika made this awesome thing. Here we go, let's jump on here. Push the button and head from the town hall and go all the way to the train station. I think I've shown the train station before. I think we've travelled on it before. But they've been expanding it a lot now. Looking at my farms, all still fairly good looking. That's nice. My tree farm, it comes straight past my tree farm. I've got to remember to come back here because I had a load of customers. Potentially all the new guys have been buying lots and lots from me. Or some of the regulars who know it's there have been buying stuff. Whee, and down we go, and ejected. It's pretty awesome, yeah. So, yeah, there we go. I'm now on the platform for the town hall. There's Peddy and Rika is next to that. We've got platforms for all sorts down here. What have we got? Platform 3 and 4. Platform 3 goes to Clay Mountain, which I believe is the minigames area. And then we've got the Skelly Farm. We've got one to the Skelly Farm that way. Rosebushes are halves again. What? Rosebush, what is going on? Anyone else have these problems with rosebushes? Look, all the rosebushes in my world are only one block tall. Meh. Manuel and the sand quarry. So it's all linked up nicely, and this place looks really cool. I think Rika probably took the lead on doing most of this, because I know she's been doing all of the railways around the place, and Peddy's been doing all sorts of redstone work to move carts around and things like that. But if you're watching their channel, then you'll probably have seen all that already. Final stop. Okay, nothing. Okay, well, this looks cool. So you've got that, yeah, and then I can go back to the town hall through there. Or we can wander about all over the place. Oh, what's that? I haven't seen this. This is a new one to me. Somebody's got a bridge. So one of the minecarts will come this way. I guess this is going to the sand quarry. Out that-a-way. It's a cool bridge, though, I like. I like the cool bridge. That's awesome. And this one here. I wonder which rail that comes from. This one here. Oh. I just hit redstone. I don't know which one it is, actually. Let's find out. This is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. 7. Really? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Janice and Nils. Ah, okay then. Or in this case, Nils and Janice. I guess I know who wrote that sign. There we go. Yeah, so that's going down there. That's cool. I might have to do something like that for myself, for my own base as well. What else? There's a new shop or something I heard was set up. New shop got set up around the place by some of the new guys. I don't see it straight away, though. It's not as obvious as I was expecting. Maybe it's down here that they've set up a shop. They've claimed one of these shops down here. Maybe. What's this? Under construction. Okay. First one you see as you walk down. These two look empty still. This one. Spare bits from the town hall build. Bunnies. Bunbelievable Fashion. That's such a cool looking shop. What's this one? Mobjop, Janice and Nils. What we got? Glowstone Dust, yeah. Redstone, Iron Ingots, Maps, Carrots, Slime Balls, Gunpowder, Sugarcane, Payment and Payment. Well, that's a lot of sugarcane. I was thinking about setting up a sugarcane farm, but I might just come here and buy the sugarcane. It's going to be a lot cheaper than setting it all up for myself. Hot MI, Scalloped Skid. It's got... Has he got any new stuff in here? Oh, he's got a fair bit of new books. That's cool. Awesome. I might come in here next time. Timmy's Store. There we go. There's a new one. New guy, Timmy. Why, Timmy, why? Why, Timmy, why? Has got... Oh, private storage there. Okay, I won't go poking my nose in. But it does look pretty cool up here. And what have we got for selling? Just some redstone bits and pieces. I see. Just some odd bits and pieces, a bit of redstone, a few comparators and repeaters and things, and there's some note blocks and pistons, yeah? Cool. And donations just head into there. That's quite a nice, cool shop. There you go. That's what the new guys have been up to on the server. I'm going to head back to the Nether Tunnel now and start doing some design work. I'm not going to be as extravagant as building this place. This place is still pretty, pretty epic, isn't it? I spent quite a lot of time building this. I'm really pleased that it's such a central point of the server. It makes it look really good. Every time I come in here, I'm like, wow, I built that. Wow, I built that. That's a big thing, and I built it. That's cool. Let's head on back. I'm going to go down and start placing some blocks and start making my nether tunnel suitable for guests. Alrighty, so I've been thinking of a bit of a colour scheme, a design, a thing going on. And I want to keep it fairly simple because I've got a very, very long tunnel to do. So I don't want to do anything that's too unmanageable, too unwieldy, too much that I can't handle. So I'm thinking of just having a little section like this duplicated all the way down. And I'm trying to figure out now whether I want to, like, alternate sections as well. So let's dump those back, for instance. Let's say... I've got a load of colourful blocks and stuff to play around with. Let's say we put a light source in there, like, okay? And then every other one, we'll put another light source, so... Pop, 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 pop. I'm so close to bedrock as well that this makes it difficult as well, to say the least. So we'll duplicate this one every other one like this down that side. And down the other side, I'm going to have the same thing with a 3-wide gap. I like my 3-wide gaps, as you probably know. Yeah, I definitely don't want them facing out like that. One, two... Got to have a lot of character and detail in the place without making it too much work, without making it to be like my life's work doing a tunnel. So maybe, just maybe, we alternate things a little bit like that. Does that stop the light? Yeah, that stops the light coming out, doesn't it? But it makes it bright, even though it stops the light. So we've still got a lighting up area like that. If I open that out, then my tunnel becomes very bright, but something could potentially spawn. No, they can't spawn because I'm going to keep a block there as well, so I don't necessarily need to worry about that. That's okay, I can do that. I can make it brighter, can make my corridor brighter, maybe alternate on the other side as well. Maybe that's a thing. Let's try like this and alternate the pattern slightly. Yeah. I just want to get the first few bays done. I call them bays, and then figure out the rest. I've got this ideal for having half slabs on the top because that makes me really speedy running down. And I also want it to look cool from inside here. So when you're going through, you can see all the cool stuff going on around it as well. Yep, give me that. Why are you going in there every time? And I didn't know whether to use prismarine blocks or stone bricks or polished diorite behind the back here. Like, polished diorite would give a nice clean look behind there. Prismarine would give us that cool look about the place. Maybe something like that. Just something different. That's not bad, actually. I quite like that. It's a bit of a difference. A bit of something cool. I don't know whether these blocks down here are right as well, though. Might want to remove those and bring these things down a section. Like, making this so that it looks like it's all the way down to the ground. Rather than sitting on the top. I think that's the thing that I want to do. Yep, there we go. Like that. And do that on all the sides. This is kind of what I've been doing over the last week. Just, I've been doing the basic grind of getting all the main section of ice done. But I've also just been messing about with testing of ideas and just playing, just to keep myself busy, really. While the wife's been busy doing other things, I've had to keep an eye on the kids. And so I've just been pottering around, seeing what I could come up with, doing a few basic tasks around the server. On all the different servers that I play on all the different series I play on, I do that from time to time, just sort of chill out doing a few bits and pieces around the place. And this week I just haven't had as much time to do things. So I hope my excuses are accepted and that there's enough there. There's enough of a good excuse for you to understand what I'm up to. Maybe. Just bring it all in level. I don't know if I want to keep like a level here that's not, that you don't bounce under. So if you go off the side, you don't get to it. But I've got the bedrock showing every now and again, which is not ideal. Not ideal. And I was thinking of having like beams going across from these sections like this to sort of tie in with the ceiling. And then maybe filling the other stuff in with stone would be a good thing. Maybe stone up down, up this way. Oh, missed that one up. There we go. A slid. That doesn't seem too bad to me. That doesn't seem too bad. I quite like that. And I could pop that into there like that as well. Oh, come on. Couldn't have done that if I tried. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad. I could potentially put flower pots and things in these sections, maybe grow some sugar cane. That could be an idea. Put a water... Oh, I can't put water sources down, can I? So I'm not going to get sugar cane anywhere soon, am I? Nope. Let's put that like that then. Put that back. Which one do I go for, though? Do I go for the prismarine with a single block, or do I go full diorite? Or do I put some more stone bricks in? I can also change the floor up as well to give me maybe a slight pattern in the floor, so I could just change like a strip here. Down I go, thank you. And get these, want them. I could potentially do a strip like that as well to do bands that we go through. Maybe not every one, maybe every couple of ones, just to add a little bit of detail. Just enough. I'm just messing with ideas. This may all change again before you next see it. But at least I'll have something to work off. Yeah, that's not too bad. I think I like this prismium design here, though. Let's get these out. We're going to have... what was it? It was... Let's do... That there. That there. Gimme. Gimme all my blocks, thank you. Put that there, yeah, that works. And that in there. Yeah, I quite like that. I quite like that as a nice simple little colour scheme that you go past on the way through. That's not bad. But how do I match that on the other side? I'm going to alternate them so the light sources don't get too over the top. But how am I going to alternate the colour scheme there? Yeah, I like that. That's good. I like that. This is onto a keeper right now. This is onto a keeper. What do I do in this sections here, though? I could put a cobblestone, stone brick sort of design going on in there. Just to mix it up a little bit, I suppose. Like, a little bit of stone, because that's nice and cheap and easy as well. A little bit of stone brick in, and maybe cobble half slabs. Or cobble... let's place this here. Maybe some cobble stairs. Let's see how they look. We have cobble stairs in there like that. Just so it's not the same all the way down. Now, that looks boring. That's boring. Let's take that out and that out. And let's throw in the diorite. Mix it up a bit. Yeah, that's not too bad. Not too bad. Could be interesting to be able to do something else as well, though, because that doesn't have any colour to it whatsoever, does it? Let's take the stone bricks out. We use a lot of stone bricks already. So let's throw some of these blocks in. That might work. Might look good. I could potentially do this design all the way down and figure out where to go from there. That's not really much happened this episode, I know. I've been doing a lot of walking around and talking and sorting things out. But hopefully it's looking good enough. Maybe that there. Maybe that one changes to be a wood. Just to mix it up a little bit. Maybe I don't need those half slabs there either. Maybe I can go like that design, alternating through. That's not bad. I'm going to tinker with it a lot more, and I will show you something next episode. Next week, hopefully I'll have something fairly good in mind for next week. I will see you then. Thank you very much for watching another episode of New Ariador. Thank you for listening to me just moan on about my week. And I will see you in the next episode very soon. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.